Today we are going to continue the same chapter, that is Glimpses of the Past. We were discussing the First War of Independence, 1857. The revolt of 1857 was the landmark in the history of India's struggle for freedom. It started on May 10, 1857. Delhi was a mute witness to a band of sepoys crossing over the Yamuna and entering Red Fort. They appealed to the aged Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah, an emperor without an authority, to take over the leadership of the revolt. He was proclaimed the Shahenshah Hindustan. The sepoys captured the city of Delhi, killed many Englishmen and ransacked many public offices. So the event was called the Uprising, the Revolt of 57, or the Sepoy Mutiny by the British. But the Indian historian called it the First War of Independence, as it was the first time that different sections of Indian society united and fought as one nation to throw off the shackles of foreign domination. Ever since the Britishers have set foot on our soil, the nation was losing its wealth and independence. They sent foreign wealth home back in England. So their motive was to exploit the resources of our country. This angered the Indians, and finally in 1857 a number of Indians revolted. So there are various causes of the revolt, like political, economic and military, social, and at the end the immediate cause. So we'll be discussing the first cause, that is political causes. The revolt, it was the outcome of the widespread resentment that had been boiling against the British for a long time. So the sepoys were dissatisfied with their treatment. The policy of annexation of Dalhousie, especially the doctrine of lapse, created fear and resentment among the Indian rulers. So the British signed many treaties with the kings and nawabs, but violated them. So the Indians, they lost all trust in British. Awadh had been an ally of the East India Company, but it was annexed on the plea that the government was not functioning properly. So this came as a shock to the Nawabs. Next comes the military cause, that the sepoys, they helped the Britishers to establish their empire in India, but instead of receiving awards or promotions, they were humiliated by the British. There was a discrimination between Indian and the British soldiers. So the highest pay given to an Indian sepoy was less than a minimum pay of a European recruit. The Act of 1856 made it compulsory for new recruit to serve overseas. Next comes the cause of social, that is the significant cause, that are social and religious causes. Like, social reforms were considered an interference in the customs and tradition of Hindus. Many Indians opposed the introduction of Western culture in India. The Hindu law, law of property was changed to enable Christian convert to receive his share of ancestral property. Moreover, the British followed a system of racial discrimination. The British considered them as superiors. They advocated judicial system based on the principle of equality, but in actual practice it was biased. Next comes the immediate cause. The immediate cause of this revolt of 1857 was the cartridges of New Enfield rifle, which has been greased by the paper cover, which had to be bitten off before the cartridge was loaded into the rifle. So it was said that the greased paper was made up of beef and pig fat. So both the Hindus and the Muslims, they refused to use them as cow is sacred to Hindus and the pig is detestable to the Muslim community. So that was the immediate cause of this revolt. This came as a spark to the first war of independence by as the young boy, that was Mangal Pandey, who refused to use the Enfield rifle and shot down his sergeant. He was arrested and tried executed. When this news spread, many sepoys started the revolt. So next comes the heroes of revolt, which we will be discussing in the next extract. Okay.